As we're traveling down this river, the jungle is thick. And I know both of us are thinking, thank God we're on the river, because it seems like impenetrable jungle. And you can imagine slogging through that.
The Amazon is the world's largest river because of the sheer volume of water it carries. During the rainy season, the water gushes at almost 10 feet per second. Local legend says 1,000 people drown per year in its murky waters.
Make no mistake about it, this river is very violent. It may look like a sleeping baby sometimes, but it's very powerful.
It's gonna be bending to the left here, Cody.
Looks rougher up there.
Yeah, I hear some water a little bit.
We turn this dog leg and boom, right in front of us, the worst case scenario, rapids.
Nope, there's no way.
To shore, Cody. We're on a raft made out of balsa wood and vines holding it together.
There's no doubt in my mind, if Cody and I go through those rapids, we're not coming out the other side. The shore.
This is literally the factor. We've got to get this boat to the side as quick as possible.
Oh, my paddle just broke. This ain't working, dude.
Go, get out of the boat.
Cody, unhook all the quick.
We gotta try to save the boat!
Dude, get out of the boat, Cody! Go! Get out of the boat!
Swim! So much for the raft. That would have been ugly. Well, you know what? We got a lot of mileage out of it. You know, this cruise just turned into a foot patrol. You ready to do some walking?
Yeah.
Our original plan was to build a raft and follow this river all the way out. That's not happening. Again, make a plan, plan on making changes. Now we're on plan B. We're bushwhacking.
Going to the jungle on land now, it's a huge calorie burn. This is extremely mountainous country. It's very slick and it's psychologically exhausting. Maybe even more so than the physical.
Man, dude, something's biting my neck right there. Do you see an animal? That's the problem with this damn place. You bump something, freaking rains bugs on you.
You're in sensory overload and you're working your body to death. You're burning through calories faster than you can replenish them.
Hey, Cody.
What?
Take a look up. See that like cluster of nuts right there?
Wish they were down here.
Yeah, me too, for sure.
Shanta palmbill trees are found throughout the Amazon rainforest. The highly nutritious fruit can be eaten raw or mashed and fermented into a drink called chicha.
Man.
Yeah, let's go.
No, hold on, dude, that's food. I mean, just let's just think
it's
about
food,
this.
But it's up there.
I know, but I definitely want to get those because we can stick them in the bag and we just have food while we're walking.
You've got to replenish your body's fuel. If you don't have fuel, you're going to run out of steam. You're just going to sit down and die.
They have calories and they have fat. That's something we need right now.
I see a target of opportunity. I'm grabbing these things, period.
I think this is worth the risk. We have a rope, and what I could do is fashion a climbing system and shimmy myself up there. If I get up this thing and I start sliding, I'll come back down.
You'll come back down at a high rate of speed.
Oh, yeah, I mean, this thing right here is like a greased telephone pole. I mean, look at this. I wish I could climb it free, but there's absolutely no way. So
I'll help you with your knots and whatever, but I'm going to stay on the ground. Well, I appreciate the calories, who wouldn't? But it wouldn't be my first course of action to be 40 feet off the ground on a tree smeared with petroleum jelly.
As a former Marine, Army Green Beret, and Special Ops veteran, Joe has extensive climbing and ropes experience, which he has utilized in both training and combat missions for over 20 years.
You can like cheer me on if you like.
The Prusik climb technique that Joe will employ is a category that the U.S. Army includes each year in its grueling Best Ranger competition.
All right, there's one. I need to make one more of these.
A Prusik climbing system is basically using a Prusik knot with a loop in it to step in, and you make another one exactly the same, you step in it. As you put your weight on one, you lift up the other one, put your weight on the opposite, and do the same thing, up, down, up, down.
It's just a huge compromising scenario. Very, very, very dangerous.
You need help?
Quiet.
I looked down at Cody, and he has the proverbial deer in a headlight look. I think he's more scared than me.
It's a scary situation. You know, we're trying to mitigate risk, but at the same time,
Joe is a highly trained professional warrior.
So I have to back off because he's a big boy and let him do his thing.
God, bless America.
Just keep doing what you're doing.
Dude, hush.
I'm trying to balance myself on my boot tips. My hands are sore and it's slick as snot. I'm 10 feet away. I can see the fruit right above me, but I am spent.
Cody! All right, Cody. Let me get these things done.
Yeah, this is dangerous territory here. It's like rain and ball bearings down here.
All right, think we got enough to fill that bag?
It looks good, man, come on down.
All right, I'm heading down. You know, I've done some risky things in my life, but I weighed the risk, I weighed the reward.
You sure don't have big nuts, but you sure got a lot of them.
We needed this for our journey. I took the risk for Cody and I. Someday, he may have to do that for me.
Kind of sweet, kind of nutty.
Full of carbs. That's what we need right now.
Want to eat on the move?
Yeah, that's exactly why I went up there for him.